Welcome to the show. Today's episode brings you a conversation on why successful Indian corporates should be investing in their sectors, nurturing entrepreneurship, and facilitating innovation. My guests today are Mark Kahn from Omnivore Ventures and Devneet Bajaj from M.I.T.R.A.
Mark Kahn is the founding partner at Omnivore Ventures, a venture fund investing in early-stage agri-tech businesses in India. Initiated by Godrej, the fund is an independent entity with a capital bank of over 250 crores. One of the startups Omnivore has invested in is M.I.T.R.A. Devneet Bajaj, M.I.T.R.A.'s founder, joins Mark to talk about the benefits of large corporates such as Godrej investing in and nurturing a strong ecosystem for startups in their focus sectors.
Mark, enlighten me. What was the motivation behind Godrej incubating a fund internally within its business and then making it an independent entity?
Godrej supported Omnivore, the launching and incubation of Omnivore, because the Godrej family and the professionals in Godrej Agrivet believed that the agricultural technology and food technology ecosystem in India needed more support than it was getting. There were clearly a large number of entrepreneurs and startups that needed capital, that needed advice, that needed connections. The whole ecosystem needed more development for it to reach its potential. And given the challenges with respect to food security, agricultural sustainability, farm productivity in India, it was very clear that this was a massive opportunity. So I think with all of that in mind, plus the intention of creating extraordinary financial returns by investing in this space, Godrej came in and helped support the creation of Omnivore. But the intent was always for it to be independent, and the rationale was clear. If this was perceived as a corporate fund, if this was seen as an extension of Godrej's balance sheet, we would never be seen as being truly aligned with the interests of the entrepreneurs and startups we were supporting. It would be like mating a bunny rabbit with an elephant, which is obviously not easy to do and likely unsuccessful. The point was to have something that in the long run entrepreneurs would want to turn to for support, and a fund that frankly would get the best deals. And the experience of corporate venture funds over sort of two decades of evidence is that they don't get the best deals. Entrepreneurs oftentimes self-select away from perceived corporate venture funds, hence why it's not called Godrej Capital, and why Godrej contributed some of the money as a limited partner, but certainly, you know, 90% came from other limited partners.
So then you tell me, what's been your experience in starting up in India, and what's it been like to get funded?
Being a bunny rabbit? it's been...
No, the idea was that we would be less large than an elephant.
Right, fair enough. The experience has been challenging.
We started off as a software business, which I still think has a lot of opportunity, but then we realized maybe a couple months into the journey that, you know, what India really needed, agriculture really needed, was a bricks and mortar business. One of the fundamental needs was to plug a labor gap that we're seeing across the country, mm-hmm. from Haryana to Assam to Maharashtra. Wherever you go, a farmer's always complaining about labor not being available to do things at the farm, which means his productivity is going down. Mm-hmm. He may have to shut down his farming operations if he doesn't get the labor. So machines was the way to go. So to answer your question, the journey when we started in 2011, 2012, up till now has been very challenging. And it's been great to have supportive investors like Mark, who, unlike, you know, a large corporate or even a very, very well-established venture capital firm, are like one of the guys. You know, they understand our vision. They understand agriculture. And they're able to sort of connect with me as an entrepreneur and think like an entrepreneur. So if I was talking to Godrej, I'd feel slightly more uncomfortable about sharing my vision and how I want to grow the business. So that's where I think, you know, from an entrepreneur's perspective, it makes sense to be for them to be a VC fund.
Devneet Bajaj was a private equity executive and investment banker before he started up in AgriTech in India. His startup is M.I.T.R.A and his first product is the Great Master, a specially designed sprayer for Indian vineyards. The attempt at M.I.T.R.A is to develop technology that will allow farmers to lower their dependency on labor, to increase their capacity for exports, and to increase income threefold. Devneet's big dream is to make M.I.T.R.A the leading innovator and manufacturer of agricultural mechanization equipment globally.
तर मी मित्र ह्या कंपनीतला ब्लोअर एप्रिल 2014 मध्ये विकत घेतला तर त्यातले फायदे सांगायचं म्हणजे की औषधाची खूप बचत होते जेच्या तिने घर डिपिंगसाठी मी शेड्यूल त्यातलंच केलं डाळिंबाती वापर केला डाळिंबाती चांगला रिझल्ट भेटतात और टनेल सर्वसाधारण 10 ते 12 टनापर्यंत माझा एक्सपोर्ट क्वालिटीचा टनेल आहे तर दरवर्षी जे रेग्युलर स्प्रे करत होतो मी त्यापेक्षा ह्या ब्लोअरमुळे औषधाची थोडी बचत झाली झाडावरती कॉर्चिंग वगैरे काही आलं नाही कुठे औषधाचे उरण दिसत नाही मित्र सांगायचं म्हणजे आपला इंडियन टेक्नॉलॉजीतला ब्लोअर आहे त्यातलं स्पेअर पार्ट आपल्याला अगदी माझ्या राहत्या गावापासून 2 तासात मी पिंपळगावला येऊन घेऊन जाऊ शकतो पण परत त्यांचे ॲम्ब्युलन्स कार आहेत तेही 2 तासात आपल्याकडे पोहोचता काही झालं तरी
वाय इज इट इम्पॉर्टंट दॅट सक्सेसफुल लार्ज इंडियन कॉर्पोरेट्स ओपन अप अँड स्टार्ट नर्चरिंग स्मॉल एंटरप्राइजेस इन द सेक्टर्स दॅट दे स्पेशलाइज इन Why is it important that they do it in sort of a fashion where there's low involvement for them anyway, where they have where they're not hands on?
I think assuming that you can do all of your R&D and product development internally in your company is a fallacy. It's the assumption that you have hired all of the best people, that all of the best people want to work in a large hierarchical corporate structure, that creative people who come up with new ideas and new technologies want to work in a large hierarchical Indian corporate structure. I think everyone realizes that that's not the case. So I think you are seeing among large Indian corporates a recognition that they need to work with startups, with entrepreneurs. My own feeling is that when large Indian corporates try to work with small startups and entrepreneurs, there is a tremendous amount of mutual frustration. You know, it could be as simple as a payments process, right? Anyone who's a startup who has a large Indian corporate as a customer will oftentimes scream bloody murder because payments are almost always delayed because the mission of the finance department is to maximize their working capital, which means delaying payment on services and goods as much as they reasonably can. Likewise, I think one of the major issues with innovation in large corporates, and I think Godrej is a bit of an exception to this,
sure,
but I would say it's more of a universal rule, is that it's very hard to innovate breakthrough technologies in large corporates because there is always some asshole that wants to kill it, no matter how good an idea it is, right? Politics is the death of innovation. It's not that you don't have brilliant people in these companies. It's just that they work for someone else and some other boss is threatened by this idea or the senior R&D guy didn't come up with it.
The motivations can be mixed up.
It's very personal. It becomes institutionally political. I'll give full marks. There's a very famous VC in the States named Ben Horowitz, who runs Andreessen Horowitz, who has basically kind of come out with this saying, this is why the venture-backed startup model has led to more innovation over the past 2 decades than the kind of old school Bell Labs model led in the decades before.
From a developmental point of view, at a national level, how important is it for large enterprises to encourage entrepreneurship in this way, to facilitate innovation and to also sort of step back and watch it bloom?
I think it's critical. I think the future of large corporates is going to be dependent on the future of entrepreneurship. Startups will become the small, then medium, then large players that become customers, suppliers, eventual acquisition targets, partners. I think it's very, very clear that what's happening at the early stage of the innovation ecosystem in India is much more aggressive and much more groundbreaking and path-breaking than what is happening in large corporates. What do you think?
I completely agree. I think we're a very young economy and even younger startup economy. And I think corporates have to get used to the fact that most innovation, in our opinion, is happening at the startup level. And they need to learn how to deal with startups. And some companies are learning how to do it. I think Mahindra, Tata are probably learning how to do it. But there needs to be a cultural change. Because we were under the license Raj, and then we moved over to corporate India. That's been the story. But the startup India story is just starting. And once startups start creating value, which they're starting to now, corporates are going to have to deal with that and learn how to pay value as well for, it's not just about payments and valuations and, revenues and numbers, but it's about the value that the startup brings. So we're going to have to go through a culture change, but I don't think that's going to be a problem. We've got a lot of bright people sitting in Indian corporates, and I think they'll adapt as time goes.
I think when you start seeing a significant migration of talent from the corporate sector to the startup sector, which we are already seeing, when the stigma of working for a startup diminishes, and I think that's happening. I think you see that in the Bangalore marriage market, where it used to be that if you told your future in-laws that you were leaving Cognizant or Infosys to work for a six-person company, you might find that you're not getting married.
Yeah.
I think there's a growing recognition in Bangalore, Hyderabad, Chennai, Pune, some of these cities that have a greater salience of startups, that this is actually a better deal, even on a risk-adjusted basis, for young people that want to have promising careers, that even if their startup doesn't work out, the level of experience, of managerial and technical experience that they'll get at a startup is infinitely higher than what they'll get at a large corporate.
And, to your point, it's a lot faster to go out there and, chase your dreams and execute something. And eventually, with having, being a part of the ecosystem and with having a fund like Omnivore, which is affiliated with Godrej, eventually the corporate does add value. Mm-hmm. When you're an established business with an established vision, they can help take it to the next level. And hopefully we're attractive to a large corporate down the road.
I mean, one day his company will probably get snapped up by a large corporate. Tata has a similar innovations fund, which again is a bit arm's length. TVS has their fund, which again has outside investors. I think there is a growing recognition that this is a better way to move an ecosystem forward and to support startups than to kind of drop your heavy corporate self all over a two-year-old company that's founded by a bunch of 27-year-olds.
Yeah, so it really seems like an entrepreneurial approach to supporting entrepreneurs and facilitating innovation. Right.
And we tend to look for, when we recruit into Omnivore, we tend to look for people that are going to be able to work with entrepreneurs as equals, right? People that don't have ridiculous corporate expectations about lifestyle or about quality of life. Generally we all travel about 80% of the time. There's a lot of rail travel, there's no hired cars for the day unless we're in the middle of nowhere. If you're in Bangalore, you're popping around in autos. If you're in Delhi, you're popping around in metro and autos. So we try to run Omnivore in a lean entrepreneurial manner, which essentially I think makes us much easier for startups and entrepreneurs to work with.
Since its launch in 2010, Omnivore has invested in 9 startups. They are SkyMet,
a provider of detailed weather forecasts to the media and farmers. Kedut, a manufacturer of automatic seed drills and planting machinery. Frontal Drain, which develops social, mobile analytics and cloud computing software for food and agribusinesses. Orohan Foods, India's pioneering pork integrator. Barracks, a developer of integrated pest management technologies. Stellabs, which builds automated tools for dairy farms. Eruvaka, a manufacturer of on-farm diagnostic equipment for aquaculture. Y-Cook, a food processing technology business. And M.I.T.R.A, which develops agricultural mechanization equipment.
Okay, let's sum it up. Three reasons you think potential investees, startups, could and should look to large enterprise-led or founded funds and build relationships with them.
Well, I think the three reasons would be a brand. When I tell a customer or a supplier or a dealer that we are affiliated with Godrej, it helps. And it helps, you know, give credibility to your startup. Secondly, I think as we get bigger and as we build systems, there are a lot of systems that large corporates have that we can borrow and learn from. Thirdly, whenever, you know, when we do have strategic sessions, we can borrow from expertise at the large corporate level. You know, guys at Godrej Agrivet that Mark's brought into some of our strategy sessions have, you know, definitely helps.
Fantastic.
And fourth reason, if I can add one, is actually that, you know, eventually we could be an acquisition target for one of these. I'm not saying we want to be one, but it's a possibility.
Oh, you want me also to answer this question? I think a lot of the large corporate backed VCs have more sectoral knowledge than a lot of the independents. You know, they've been started for specific reasons. All of us in Omnivore have a strong understanding of agricultural technology and food technology, much greater than kind of generalists would. I think that's one very good reason. I think I agree with Devneet that there are, I would say, more broadly strategic linkages that can be leveraged, that can deliver significant amounts of value to a startup. Again, processes, sales networks, sometimes even very, very, very senior relationships with potential customers, suppliers, companies abroad, etc. I also think there's another side to it, which is that I think that in general, the corporate-backed venture funds have, especially ones that have drawn their talent from corporates, have a greater understanding of the difficulty of doing business here, mm-hmm. As opposed to a lot of guys who've sat in Silicon Valley for a decade and
so
come
the
over here.
Cultural contextual knowledge comes to play.
Absolutely.
Yeah. You know, I've had most of my career in Indian corporates, and so understand what it is to do business here, and how it is very, very different from, you know, how it is very, very different from kind
from
of
the US.
From the US, and in particular Silicon Valley.
Yeah, fair.
Mark, Devi, thank you so much for your time. It's been fantastic hearing your inputs, and I really hope we all see more and more corporates venturing out, nurturing their sectors and nurturing innovation.
Thank you. Thank you for having us.
Thank you for having us.
I hope you enjoyed that conversation with Mark and Devneet. Leave us a comment, and we especially want to hear from you if you're an aspiring or budding entrepreneur. Don't forget to subscribe. Thank you.
If you enjoyed that conversation, here's more.